Let's welcome in Horizon Therapeutics Chairman and CEO Tim Walbert. Tim, great to have you with us.
Great to be on again, Melissa. Thank you.
Specifically for the drug that treats TED, the thyroid eye disease, Tepezza, you've raised your peak sales guidance to more than $200 million, and that's from just $30 to $40 million. That implies that you have really good visibility into what will happen when it even comes to resuming healthcare activity. What are you seeing that makes you this confident? Sure.
We have the benefit of the medicine getting approved 2 months early on January 21st, and that gave us 2 months to get out, educate physicians, educate patients. And if you look at these patients, they had 6% of them can potentially go blind, 50 to 70% of them get double vision, as well as pain and severe disfigurement. So these patients want to take action. So we built a significant number of patients with prescriptions that were waiting to get treated right before the COVID-19 situation. So as we announced in our earnings call last week, we have over 1,500 patients that are awaiting treatment. 200 of them were treated in the first quarter with just under $24 million in sales. So we've seen strong demand, patients willing to take action, even in spite of the COVID-19 situation we're facing.
So as I understand what you're saying, Tim, are you saying that hospitals, even in cities and areas that are really dealing with the impact of COVID, that these patients are still able to get new prescriptions that are written now as opposed to just still the ones that had the prescription in place prior to the pandemic?
Sure. We are seeing new prescriptions come in every day. The benefit here is these patients are not being infused in the hospitals. We've been able to create a network of about 700 infusion centers, of which in the first quarter, 150 of these infusion centers that are the infused cancer medicines, they are outside of the hospital setting. So we're able to work with our patient services team and point patients to the right infusion center to ensure they get their treatment. So we haven't been impacted by the situation facing hospitals regarding COVID-19.
So you're optimistic about the patient uptake when it comes to Tepezza, but also you indicated that you're optimistic, or it sounded like it was promising for your chronic gout treatment, Krystexxa, as well, with your backlog of patients. Is there conservatism built into these forecasts in that once activity resumes, healthcare activity in full, that there could actually be upside to the number of patients you're expecting in that backlog and wanting to take these drugs?
Well, first of all, with Krystexxa, we had a great first quarter, $93.3 million, up 78% year over year, on track for a great start. What we've seen there is patients are generally hesitant, new patients, to go to a rheumatologist's office. In fact, we've seen rheumatology visits as a whole down about 70% due to COVID-19. So our existing patients taking Krystexxa continue to get their infusions. We haven't seen much drop off there. What we have seen is a slowing down of new patients going to rheumatologist offices and being able to get infused with Krystexxa. So we built a database of about 1,500 patients. We expect that as healthcare activities begin to resume back to normal, we'll be able to start generating and converting that database into patients that can get the benefits of Krystexxa. Relative to conservatism, I think with Tepezza, if mm-hmm. we're able to get back in a more normal activity mm-hmm. Here in the third quarter, I think we can certainly drive significant upside. Right. What we did say is that without COVID-19, we would have been raising guidance substantially greater than we did. Mm-hmm.